Your heartbeat. A familiar sound that reminds you you're alive. So familiar, many of us don't even realize just how hard our hearts are working. The heart pushes 2,000 gallons of blood to the farthest reaches of your body each day. And it takes a single red blood cell less than 1 minute to move through the heart, out into the rest of your body, and back again. This is your circulatory system, and it includes a body-wide network of veins, arteries, and capillaries that, if unwound, measure more than 60,000 miles long. You can think of it as a series of highways your blood uses to get where it needs to go. Each individual red blood cell is like a delivery truck, bringing oxygen, nutrients, and hormones to remote areas of your body. Those same vehicles are responsible for picking up toxins, carbon dioxide, and waste. Imagine then that your heart is a roundabout at the center of your circulatory system. Its sole function is to keep your blood moving from one end of your body to the other. When a blood cell shows up at the heart for the first time, it's burdened with carbon dioxide and lacking in oxygen. Your body needs oxygen to do everyday things like move, eat, think, and feel. So the heart must redirect blood cells toward the lungs to drop off CO2 and pick up oxygen. A red blood cell first enters the right atrium of the heart through your body's largest veins, the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. Your right atrium is the first of four heart chambers your red blood cells pass through. But your blood doesn't flow through all four chambers consecutively. Instead, it has to enter and exit the right side of your heart before making its way over to the left side. A wall of tissue called the septum separates the right side of your heart with the oxygen-starved blood from the left side with the oxygen-rich blood. When your atrium is full, the tricuspid valve opens like a gateway into the second chamber, called the right ventricle. Once blood fills the right ventricle, your tricuspid valve closes and your heart contracts. This squeezing forces other gateways, called pulmonary valves, to open, so that your blood can be pushed out through pulmonary arteries towards your lungs. Your lungs then scrub your blood cells clean of any CO2 and refill them with oxygen so that they can deliver it to other areas of the body. But before it reaches its destination, your blood has to go back through the heart. The oxygen-rich blood enters through your pulmonary veins into your left atrium, through the mitral valve into your left ventricle, and out again through the aorta, until it reaches where it needs to go. Once it delivers the oxygen, the red blood cell returns back towards the heart to start the journey all over again. This cycle happens within fractions of a second, with the right and left sides of your heart contracting and releasing simultaneously. And that familiar heartbeat? It's actually the sound of your valves opening and closing in perfect harmony.